Gurur Brahma, Gurur Vishnu, Gurur Devo Maheshwara, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha, Satchidananda Rupaya, Vishvotpatyadihetave, Tapatraya Vinashaya, Shri Krishnaya Vayam Numaha, Shri Krishnaya Vayam Numaha. Om Yonda Pravishya Mama Vacham Imam Prasuktam Sanjeevayatyakila Shakti Karaswadamnam Anyashcha Hasta Charana Shravanatva Gadi
Srimad Bhagavatam, 11th Canto, and we are going to start the 14th chapter, Chaturdashodhyaya. Last week, we concluded the 13th chapter, which was about the Hansa Gita. That infinite, formless Lord, by the call of a devotee, Brahmaji in that case, to bless him, to guide him, took a form and appeared. And see how symbolic it is. He appeared as Hamsa. Hamsa means, what did we say? The one which has the ability to discriminate between milk and water. So, what it is indicating, that it has the discriminative ability. So, when we have in our intellect, Brahmaji is the supreme intellect, total intellect, we have teeny-meeny intellect. So in this intellect, when the ability to discriminate gets inaugurated, understand Hams has taken avatar in your mind, in your intellect. It is the grace. And it will take you in that direction. In the direction as the Lord in the form of Hams has guided Brahmaji as well as the Sanat Kumaras, and through Sanat Kumaras us. And what did he say there? He says so there are many paths in this whole chapter. The Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti, all this was talked about. So much Tattva Vivek was given. Tattva, essence, Vivek, discrimination. So much discrimination, it's almost Vedanta for 2-3 classes. It seems that way, that we are following the path of knowledge, but we are in Bhagavatam. But don't forget, what? That the culmination of knowledge is devotion, and the culmination of devotion is knowledge. Don't forget that. It's how you look at it. It's how you look at it. Just like woman is one, someone looks at her and calls her wife, another one looks at her and calls her mother. When you look at this, what do you call? Oh, ye to gyaniyo ka tha. No, Bhagwan himself is saying it. Then where is your attention? Is your attention on the knowledge? Or is your attention on the who he is? So in this manner, in this whole, after this whole chapter, the Lord said the best way to come out of it is to stop thinking about, remember the question? We have repeated it 4 classes now. 5th time I am asking you to repeat. What was the question? How does the mind get attached to the objects of the world? And second question was, how do the objects of the world create impression in the mind. This was the question, and for that such a big Ramayana was given, or the Lord had to take birth, take manifestation to answer this question. And the conclusion of that question was, this is a wrong question. Why? Because as long as you keep asking questions about the world, what is the world? Everything other than the divine or divinity is the world, isn't it? Everything other than the Ishvara is the world. And how do you distinguish between Ishvara and the world? That which is changing is the world. That which is changeless is the Lord or the divine. So find out in you what is not changing and what is changing. So whatever is changing, keep discarding it ruthlessly. No point to indulge. And that, this point, the changing point, was taken up from the beginning itself in the 13th chapter. Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti, waking, dream and deep sleep are the three states which keep coming and going. They're changing from childhood to today. Body is continuously changing, breath is continuously changing, emotions are continuously changing, intellect, knowledge is continuously changing, thoughts are continuously changing, concepts are continuously changing. Discard. Then what do you do? But we can't discard everything, no? That is also a problem. We don't know how to. We don't know how to. Because the phenomena we didn't create, it happened. I didn't decide that I'm going to enter this body. This birth happened. Death will also happen. So how do I get out of this phenomena? Lord says, by not asking these type of foolish questions. Because this question is about prakriti. Prakriti is that which is changing. So you're talking about how does the mind get attached? And how do the objects attach to the objects? And how the objects get make impressions in the mind? By this getting, he gave the answer. And the answer was that whenever you involve yourself more than required with any object, it leaves an impression in your mind. So what is to be done? Stop getting involved. How do you do that? How do you do that? Like right now, so many things are there in this room. You are not involved with everything in the room or with every person in the room. You know they are there, but you are not involved in it. You are only involved if you at this very moment. Your mind is, say, 90%, 95% available to what you are hearing. Isn't it? I hope. But it's also aware, but it's not creating any issue in your mind. Exactly the same way. Go through life not interacting with the objects of the world, with the experiences of the world, with too much intensity. Theek hai, chalta hai. This will also pass away. Move on. What's next? Swamiji, ho gaya lecture, aage kya hai? Chalo khana khate hain. What's next? Bilkul. Haste khelte pass through life. Don't take it too seriously. When you become serious means you have given undue importance to some aspect of the creation which is making you serious. And seriousness means impressions. See? This was the answer. He answered that question. And that's what forms the impressions, and these impressions become the cause of your future births. This is the reason we got this particular body. Now, having given the answer, Bhagawan said that don't worry about this type of questions. Instead, think about me. If you want to come to me, if you want to attain salvation, if you want to attain the self or the divine, by asking these questions, you are not going to reach anywhere. It's not going to satisfy anything. Mind will come up with another question after some time. So, now, having told this, now we enter into the conclusion was, इति मे छिन्न संदेहा मुनय सनकादयः सभाजयित्वा परया भक्त्या गृणत संस्तवैः. Having duly worshipped me with supreme devotion, the sages Sanaka and his three brothers, who had their doubts as to the way in which the mind could be weaned from the objects of senses, thus resolved by me in the form of the divine swan, the Hamsa, celebrated me through songs of praise. जब आखिर में जाके भजन कीर्तन ही करना है तो शुरू से क्यों नहीं करे? See? Then, तैरहं पूजित सम्यक संस्तुत परमर्षिभिः प्रत्ययाय स्वकं धाम पश्यत परमेष्ठिनः. Honored with due ceremony and glorified at length by the addressed great sages, I flew back to my divine realm. That Lord, divine Paramatma, who had taken the form of a swan, again went back to his original form, which is what? Which is formless. Realm, Brahma, the highest functionary of the universe, looking on. So, this is exactly the way. Many times when you are sitting in the satsang or sitting in a bhajan kirtan, suddenly something clicks inside and you are at one with yourself. Something suddenly clicks while listening. Same thing you are listening so many times in so many satsang, but it clicks in one day. It's not because of your concentration. It's not because of your availability. It was because of the grace of the Lord. Never take ownership of it. Never take ownership of it. That whatever is happening in my life is happening by His grace. Now, you are all nodding. So now, this nod will be explained in this 14th chapter. That is, everything is happening by His grace. What is Ananya Bhakti? So here, Atha Chaturdasho Dhyayaha, the chapter 14, glory of the path or devotion and the process of meditation is described in this chapter. Uddhava Uvacha, remember it is still Uddhava Gita going on. It's a whole, this 11th canto of the Bhagavatam, it is called the most important canto of the whole Bhagavat Mahapurana. Eknath Maharaj, you have heard, no? The one who found Jnaneshwar Maharaj after 300 years, I told you. He wrote commentary only on the 11th canto, not rest of the Bhagavat. Because in this chapter, everything is included. Yoga Marg, Kriya Marg, Bhakti Marg, Sankhya Marg, the Vedanta, everything is included in this. उद्धव उवाच वदन्ति कृष्ण श्रेयांसि बहूनि ब्रह्मवादिनः तेषां विकल्प प्राधान्य उताहो एकमुख्यता भवतो दाहृतः स्वामिन् भक्तियोगो नपेक्षितः निरस्य सर्वतः संगम येन त्वय्या विशेन्मनः. He says, Uddhava says, exponents of Veda speak of many a course of discipline leading to final beatitude, O Krishna. Does their importance vary according to the choice of the striver, or does prominence attach to only one of them? The discipline of devotion by recourse to which the mind, having shaken off attachments for all others, gets fixed on you, has been declared by you as independent of other disciplines, O my master. In other words, what you are saying, you are explaining so many different things. I just told you, Vedanta, Sankhya, Yoga, different things were told. And then you are telling that devotion also. Which one should I follow? This is our confusion also. When people say simply, स्वामी अभी परसों ही किसी ने मेरे को फ़ोन किया व्हेन आई वाज एट द एयरपोर्ट व्हेन आई वाज कमिंग बैक फ्रॉम इंडिया एंड स्वामी जी डू यू हैव अ मिनट आई सेड आई एम जस्ट गेटिंग टू बोर्ड द फ्लाइट नहीं स्वामी जी जस्ट वन मिनट क्या ऑस्ट्रेलिया से आया पता नहीं कहाँ से आया था आई डोंट नो दैट पर्सन यस स्वामी जी माई माइंड इज़ वेरी डिस्टर्ब्ड आई सेड व्हाट हैपेंड I also, if someone is saying disturbed, okay, you give extra few minutes, no? So I said, okay, tell me what is that. No, oh, sometimes us samay navratri chal rahi thi na. She says, I have been initiated into Krishna mantra and the navratri is going on, I don't know which one to take. I want to take Devi's name. Then I started with Durga. Now that when I came back, it was Navratri, the Saraswati. So Durga is also coming, Lakshmi is also coming, Saraswati is also coming, and Krishna is also coming. Now I'm confused and mere se meditation nahi ho raha hai. Kya karenge? Yehi apna haal hai. Should I follow the path of devotion? Should I follow the path of yoga? Should I do pranayama? Should I do karma yoga? Should I follow my duty? What is my dharma? What is my dharma? One hand is the family on the side, children, parents. Is that my duty, or is it my duty towards the Lord? Which is my duty? And that answer Bhagavan only gives. Sarva dharman parityajya mamekam sharanam vraja. He is saying, your supreme duty is to give up everything and come to me, mame kam sharanam, come and surrender at my feet, or come and surrender to me, I'll sort out everything. But we think as human beings that we are more intelligent than God. That is our problem. We are going to teach him what to do. Arey Bhagwan, aapko kya pata yaar? You know, you are sitting somewhere above the clouds, or somewhere they say you are there in the temple, you are there in the Kailash, but you know, my child was beaten by the student, by the other friend. Now what do? I have to take action. This is practical. Bhagavad Gita is okay, but this is practical going on. That is where you have to practice it. But hum isi mein kho jate hain. So there are two ways. What is that? What are the two ways? As long as your attention is on the world, as long as your attention is on the world, you must follow the karma mark. Do your duty, take care of your parents, take care of your children, take care of this, take care of income, take care of everything, society, take care of the nation, whatever, wherever your attention. Oye, dhire dhire baat karo. Push, 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 chal raha hai yahan pe. Peeche jaake baitho, baatein kar lo peeche. Go, go, go. Kahan tha main abhi? Karma karo. Daantne mein laga hua tha. Wahan tha. Daantne mein laga hua tha. Par ye bhi badmash hai. Dekhte hain, hanste hain, meri gussa chala jata hai, main kya karu? So as long as our attention is on the world, we are bound to think about our family and children and duties that we have to carry out in the world. And as long as you are entangled in this, as long as you are entangled in this, till then Bhagavad Dharma has not got inaugurated in your heart. You may go to 100 times, you go to temples, from morning till evening you do puja, but Bhagavad Dharma has not been invoked in your heart and mind if your predisposition is towards the world. Impossible. Think, now this is something you don't have to feel bad, you don't have to feel good, just make this subtle adjustment inside that everything that is happening because of him. Over. And remember that every moment, in every experience. That's it. It's not this versus that. But as long as we are extroverted in our disposition, till then Bhagavad Dharma is not possible. For that, you have to turn inwards. For that you have to become introvert. You have to seek out the Lord in your heart. Very rare ones are there who can seek it out in a stone outside or in their child outside. Very rare ones. Don't think you are that one. Start going. If it has to happen, it will happen. Huh? So here he says, the continuing in the next verse, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Now he will explain all this now. That Kalena Nashta Pralaye Vaniyam Veda Sanshnita Mayadau Brahmane Prokta Dharmo Yasyam Madatmakaha Tena Prokta Chaputraya Manave Manave Purva Jayasa Tato Mrusha Bhrugvadayo Grunhan Sapta Brahma Maharshayaha Tebhya Petribhyastat Putra Devadanava Guhyakaha Manushya Siddha Gandharvaha Savidya Racharanaha Kim Deva Kinnaranaga Raksha Kim Purushadayaha Bahmanyastesham Prakritayo Rajasattvatamo Bhuvaha Yabhir Bhutani Bhidyante Bhutanam Tatha Prakriti Sarvesham Chitravacha Sravantihi Evam Prakriti Chitriyat Bhidyante Matayo Nrunam Paramparyena Keshanchit Pakhanda Matayo Pare Manmaya Mohitadhyaha Purusha Purusharshabaha Shreyo Vadantyane Kantam Yatha Karma Yatha Ruchi Dharma Meke Yashaschanye Kamam Satyam Damam Shamam Anye Vadanti Swartham Va Aishwaryam Tyaga Bhojanam Kechid Yajna Tapodanam Vratani Niyaman Yaman Adyantavanta evaisham Loka karvane mitaha Dukho darkastamo nishthaha Kshudrananda shucha pitaha Dukho darkastamo nishthaha Kshudrananda shucha pitaha. Bhagwan is explaining to him that why there are so many different paths. Why can't it be so simple? And for different periods of time, here is, I'm saying this, that for different periods of time, different paths are appropriate. Right? Just like, why a woman cannot be only a mother? Then who will do the dishwashing? Then, if only one role, then big problem, no? It has to be according to the place, time, and the person in front. According to that, a person behaves in a particular way. So here he says, Bhagwan says, Kalena Nashta Pralaya, when the pralaya took place, when the deluge, the total deluge took place, Vaniyam Veda Sanjnita. In course of time, this word of mine bearing the name of Veda, in which stands described the course of conduct helping one to fix one's mind on me, disappeared during pralaya, the period of final dissolution. At the beginning of the next creation, however, it was delivered to me by Brahma. Now, take it subjective. When the total pralaya was there, what happened? The Veda, which is, what is Veda? What is it?
Scriptures.
Scriptures. What else?
Lord's voice.
Yes, it is the speech of the Lord. So when pralaya took place and everything was, all the differences vanished, speech can function only in differences. Understand? There has to be an other. God does not need to speak to himself. There has to be other in order to speak, for him to speak. And that's when speech comes up. But that got became unmanifest. It lupt ho gayi. Same thing happens to you every night when you go to sleep. Because there's no sense of otherness in sleep, so no speech. Isn't it? And then when you wake up, what happens? Here it says, it was delivered to me by Brahma. Who is the creator? Brahmaji. Isn't it? So the force which presents the entire multiplicity in front of you is Brahmaji. Because that is his job description. Brahmaji at individual level, what is it? At your level? Intellect. See? And immediately it makes you aware that there is something called speech. But what is our speech? Tu, tu, mai, mai. Me versus you. Like versus dislike. Aaj ye ho gaya, kal wo ho jayega. Isi mein phase rehte. But what is Vedvani? Vedvani, or even Bhagavat, if for that matter. All the scriptures, which is called the speech of the Lord, it has got only one purpose. What is that? To sing the glory of the divine, to bring everyone's mind back to the divine, towards the source. Is your interaction with your children bringing the attention of the child to the divine? Is your interaction with your wife or husband or friends, your speech is such that you are invoking the divine in them? Yes, I invoke the Mahishasur Mardini. Divine. Socho. If you just think about this itself, integrity. Last time we were talking about integrity of our personality, isn't it? Automatically integrity will come. You don't have to try. Sach bolo, jhoot mat bolo. Sach kaun sa, jhoot kaun sa, isi mein pareshan ho jate hain. Isn't it? Bhagwan ka naam lo. Aapne aap, everything will get synchronized. So here he says that at the time of pralaya, the speech got lost, meaning the Vedas got lost. And when the next cycle of creation came, because what is happening at the totality level, macrocosmic level, is exactly the same thing is happening at the micro level. If they are talking about in Puranas at the macro level, you have to apply it at the micro level. That's what I'm saying, that when you go to sleep, pralaya is taking place. So look at it in this light. And when you come up, when you wake up, again, by the grace of Brahmaji, multiplicity is there, speech also comes. But what are you using your speech for? Utte hi. Chai bani kya? Chini kam hai. Bhagwan ka naam nahi aata. Chai ka naam aata hai. तेन प्रोक्ता च पुत्राय मनवे पूर्वजायसा ततो भृग्वादयो गृह्णन् सप्त ब्रह्म महर्षयः. And by Brahma again it was taught to his eldest son Swayambhu Manu. So now the whole creation, how the creation came about. Brahmaji taught it to Swayambhu Manu. Swayambhu Manu taught it to the seven rishis, and their names are given here. It was taught to his eldest son Swayambhu Manu, also to the seven great seers associated with the creation of the universe, and they were Bhrigu. Their names are given here. What are they?
Names are mentioned, but the seven Saptarishis
सप्त ऋषि वो कौन कौन से हैं, भृगु, अत्रि, वशिष्ठ, भारद्वाज, ऋतु, अनुभव ऋषि वॉज नॉट देयर, ही इज पुटिंग हिज हैंड अप, कश्यप एंड वन मोर अंगिरस गौतम. सम प्लेसेस देयर इज सेवन, सम प्लेसेस देयर इज नाइन. भृगु, अंगिरा, मरीचि, पुलह, अत्रि, पुलस्त्य एंड क्रतु, एंड क्रतु, दीज वेर द सप्त ऋषिज टू होम दिस नॉलेज वॉज गिवन बाय ब्रह्माजी अलॉन्ग विद हिज एल्डर सन स्वयंभू मनु. रिमेंबर नाउ, स्वयंभू मनु केम वेन, हु वॉज द फर्स्ट फर्स्ट चाइल्ड ऑफ ब्रह्माजी, सनत कुमारास, देन आफ्टर सनत कुमारा नारद मुनि जी, आफ्टर नारद मुनि नो नो सप्त ऋषि एंड देन दीज एंड द स्वयंभू मनु एंड देन फ्रॉम देम तेभ्य पितृभ्यस्तत्पुत्र देवदानव गुह्यकाः मनुष्या सिद्ध गंधर्वाः स विद्याधर चरणाः. इन द फिफ्थ वर्स ही सेज दैट फ्रॉम देम, दैट इज फ्रॉम दीज मनु एंड द सेवन ग्रेट ऋषिज द फादर्स ऑफ क्रिएशन देयर प्रोजनी द गॉड्स द दानवास द गुह्यकास द यक्षास द ह्यूमन बीइंग्स द सिद्धास द गंधर्वास इंक्लूडिंग द विद्याधराज एंड द चरणास as well as men of other dvipas, divisions of the terrestrial globe other than Jambudvipa, Kinnaras, Nagas, Rakshasas, Kimpurashas and others received it. Knowledge is the same. Understand, Veda is not the birthright of Indians. Veda is, the Vedas, they are universal. And they are the birthright of every creature that is born in this creation. Question is, how does he interpret it? That is the question. See? So what all really, you may say there is Christian, there is Hindu, there is Baha'i, there is Islam, there is Zoroaster, and there is Sikhism and Buddhism. It goes on and on, and many more will come and many have gone away. Chote mote to aate rehte jaate rehte hai na? But understand, Vedas do not discriminate with any one of them. Everyone first is a Sanatan Dharmi, meaning he is the, in him, if he chooses to, he can invoke the Vedas within himself. But we, because of the circumstances that we are born in, the family that we are born in, the environment that we are born in, the lineage that we are born in, we tend to follow something or the other, isn't it? We call ourselves Hindus. But our ancestors never called themselves Hindus. Never. They only called themselves Sanatan Dharmis. Nowadays a new, following is there, and they call themselves, kya bolte hain, Dayanand Saraswati walon ko kya bolte hain, Arya Samaji, we are Arya Samaji, we are not Sanatan Dharmi. Kisko bevkoof bana rahe ho? If you call yourself, and see, there is nothing wrong calling yourself Arya Samaji, but the intention is that we are not Sanatan Dharmi, we are Arya Samaji. So who are Sanatan Dharmis? According to their definition, those who pray to Murti Puja. And who are Arya Samajis? Those who do only no Murti Puja. But you are praying to fire. Fire is also a form. Why this hypocrisy? Why this hypocrisy? No, we are only, we follow Vedas. This book of Veda, it is also a form. They don't understand that. Within that they will create divisions. So every allowed. God does not stop anyone from you. As many people on this planet, that many religions can be there. No problem. But for a very special sorted out being, this will click. What is that? That Sanatan Dharma is one. It is the foundation of all cultures and religions. It is the foundation of the entire creation, for that matter. Because first came the, every religion says, first came the word. And what is the word? Word came from the divine. And that word itself is the scripture, the Veda. And you take Hinduism, today's Hinduism, Om. You take Islam, Ameen. You take Christianity, Amen. Buddhism, Om, Hum, they say, Hum. In every religion, this word in somewhere, with some distortion, it is there. Completely, it is only in the Sanatana Dharma. Then what do yogis do? They break that one out. Ah, ooh, hmm. Break it up. Usko bolna om, pura bolna hai. Ah, ooh. Usko bhi break kar de. Pura leke koi achha nahi lagta unko. So this Veda, Bhagwan is saying, it was given to the Saptarishis. How many continents are there? Hey, kids, how many continents are there on the planet? Good. Saptarishis, seven rishis, seven continents, isn't it? Each one for each continent. And then they spread that knowledge with their understanding. With their understanding to that particular. See, like Shukracharya, he is great, isn't it? But he always teaches only Dhanavas because that is his propensity. Whereas our Brihaspati, he will never teach. He will teach only the Devas, isn't it? Similarly, every person in any given environment will behave in a particular way. People will not behave the same way. Now, Saptarishis are there. They are, each one is independent. Each one is unique. How he interprets life, can I tell you how you interpret life? I can tell you. Anubhav, I can interpret. I am going out with your mom for a coffee. So we cannot interpret. We can't even come to know what you are thinking right now. Isn't it? So how do you, what is your take of life? Your take, at this moment, your take of this satsang is in a particular manner. Is it like this every time? It's also changing. But yes, you can say, in general, throughout your life, there are certain principles, a certain disposition with which you are leading your life. Similarly, these rishis also. They had us. Who was this? Vashishta. Vashishta was Karmakandi. He was Karmakandi. Vishwamitra was completely different. Even rishis were fighting. Vashishta was not fighting, but Vishwamitra, when he was raising himself to be a rishi, because of his background, he behaved in a very different way. Gautam Rishi behaved in a different way. He cursed his own wife. Atri Rishi, he took his wife Anusuya as an equal. Each one is different. One rishi is taking her equal, another one is cursing and making her into a stone. Look at it. So now, if you can see this, same thing, if you read Bhagavad Gita today or Bhagavatam today, you are understanding in a particular, just one paragraph. Next time you come and look at it, you will find a different interpretation in your mind itself. Similarly, these seven rishis, they understood the Vedas in their own way. Now take present day example. Shankaracharya How did he interpret the Bhagavad Gita? As the Advait, path of knowledge. Advait. Advait means the non-dual philosophy he propagated by studying Bhagavad Gita. Now the same Bhagavad Gita was also studied by Madhavacharya. What did he get out of the Bhagavad Gita there?
Dvait.
Yeah. Dvait, that there is only duality. Now which one is? And then third one, Ramanujacharya came. He read the same Bhagavad Gita and wrote a commentary, and all these commentaries are available. And what did he see? Vishishtadvaya, specific non-duality. Bhagavad Gita is one. And then one more, Bal Gangadhar Tilak. He also, during the freedom struggle, he studied the same Bhagavad Gita in the jail. And according to the need of the time, each one did according to the need of the time. He interpreted the Bhagavad Gita as Karma Yoga only. Only as Karma Yoga. Now you take the same Bhagavad Gita, you read the commentary of Paramahansa Yogananda, you know, the transcendental meditation guru. Bhagavad Gita, there is nothing is told about the way he explains that here in this verse it is told do this pranayama and that pranayama and then this kriya and that kriya. But that is the way he is interpreting it. So you see, even today's time, every person who is giving lecture or doing satsang with Bhagavat, each one, yesterday mom was seeing something, one small child, 8-9 year old, fluently giving on Bhagavad Gita, okay, Bhagavat something, 8-9 year old, without any the shlokas are just pouring out of his mouth. Kaise? So you understand that even though there are differences, important thing is not that these differences are there. Important thing to remember is the way the knowledge is one. Because it is appearing in many different ways. Jnana, Bhakti, Kriya, Yoga, Hatha Yoga, Raja Yoga, Kundalini Yoga, etc. The knowledge has not become many. Just because one movement is interacted with by many people in different ways, as mother, daughter, sister, wife, the woman has not become many. She is one. Exactly the same way. The Vedas are one. They are the foundation of this creation. In fact, what is not given in Vedas is not there in creation. And also, Vedas, even though they explain the creation, their main purpose to explain the creation is not to indulge in it, but to wean your mind away from the creation towards the divine theme. But we forget the divine theme and we get lost in sattva, rajas, tamas, waking only. Forget about dream and deep sleep also. Only in waking we are lost. मेरे बेटे की शादी हो रही, मेरे बेटी की शादी हो रही, मेरे को यहाँ पे दर्द हो रहा है, मेरे को वहाँ पे दर्द हो रहा है. So here all these different people, different Saptarishi we did, and then they are talking about this. Kim Purushas and Rakshasas and Nagas and Kinnaras. See, even here, who was Hanumanji? He was Kim Purush. Kim Purush. So Kim Purush, Kim means a question. Kim Purush, Kim means a question. What? Purush means what man? But actually it is Hanumanji. Now he is neither man nor he is the vanar yoni. So how would he be interpreting the knowledge? You can't even imagine. How does a Rakshasa who is so extroverted, who is so rajasic, who is so into me and mine, how does he interpret this knowledge? Because we see the Asuras and Rakshasas doing terrible sacrifices and getting the boons from the God, isn't it? They invoke the Lords. How they are interpreting the same Vedas? Look at Ravana. He also studied the Vedas. But in what manner he studied the Vedas? He conquered the three worlds. Come on. Three worlds means from the totality point, Bhurvasva. But from individuality, waking dream and deep sleep, he conquered. By studying the Vedas, by invoking the potential within him. And he did tapasya and he got the boon. But what did he want? Did he go to the goal that the Vedas are indicating? He knew the Upanishads. Look at Hiranyakashyapu. He also knew the complete knowledge given by Hiranyakashyapu to Kayadu. Hiranyaksha is, not Kayadu, the wife of Hiranyaksha. It's nothing but what is Vedanta. But in his own life, he was not able to practice. He wanted to become immortal with body. And when it was his brother's death, he was telling his elder brother's wife that body is nashwar, body comes and body goes, soul never dies, it is consciousness ever remains. But when it came to apply on himself, I want to be immortal with body. See the hypocrisy. Are we practicing this hypocrisy in our life? If you are coming to satsangs, if you are doing pujas, if you are going to temples, and still after that you think even of someone doing, manipulate someone else or do bad to someone else or steal money from someone else or remain, be jealous of someone else or be angry at someone else, then all that was an hypocritical behavior. Then you are not a devotee. Think. Don't nod, otherwise I'll come to know who is making mistake. Sit still. But these are the points when we study the scriptures like this, that it's digging into our core and making us aware, hey, this is where I'm going wrong. This is where I'm going wrong. If I'm studying scriptures, I've got no reason, I cannot be a complaint box in life. My life must be an expression of joy and laughter. Of Paramanand, not of Dukhanand. Dukhanand karke koi cheez nahi hoti na. Hoti hai kya? Ye oxymoron ho gaya. Dukh bhi aur anand bhi. See? So if this also you remember, that if we have studied scriptures, if we have gone to a satsang, if we are having a Guru Maharaj, or if we are a devotee of a God, of a law, of any deity, then our life must become an expression of bliss. Everything that you see, hear, touch, feel, taste, think, feel, do, everything should be an expression of bliss. Any corruption in that, you need to fix it straight away. It has only, if there is a corruption, which means we have forgotten the divine and we have thought about the world. So here, he says, where are we? Diverse are the natural tendencies of the aforementioned, born as they are of varied proportions of rajas, sattva and tamas, due to which created beings and their thoughts too differ, and in conformity with their nature, indeed, diverse interpretations of the Vedas flow from the mouths of them all. So now you are, the reason. Here I was telling you before what? Because of the lineage that you are born in, the genetic code that has gone in, the environment that you are born, the society that you are, all that is. Here it's going to the source now. Every person is born from the mixture of sattva, rajas, tamas. What is the proportion of sattva, rajas, tamas? Meaning purity, dynamism and laziness. In us, laziness is more. So what is the proportion? There are how many? 20, 30 people here. Each person is different. Every moment. So naturally, if the proportion is different, your interpretation of life will be different. Because the thoughts, if you are having a rajasic thought ruling your mind, then your interpretation of life is rajasic. Remember I told you, Shankaracharya is talking of Vedanta, Ramanujacharya is talking of Vishishta, Advaita, and Madhavacharya is talking about Dvaita, Bal Gangadhar Tilak is talking about karma, and Paramahansa Yogananda is talking about Kriya Yoga. We're reading the same Bhagavad Gita. Similarly, when we are in the sattvic mode, we are calm, cool, unaffected, undisturbed. When we study or we look at life, everything is fine. But when rajas is, activity is the name of the day, we get tense. We interact differently. Ye karna hai, wo karna hai, aise karna hai, waise karna hai. Ye nahi hua toh kya hoga, wo nahi hua toh kya hoga. Because sattvic thoughts is naturally calm and rajasic thoughts are naturally of this type. Ye nahi hoga toh kya hoga. Doubt comes, frustration comes. That is the nature of rajasic. And for a tamasic person, he comes to Bhagavad or Bhagavad opens the Bhagavad Gita, like I used to once upon a time in Switzerland. Krishna, Hare Krishna people were going and they were dancing and I'm feeling shy to dance with them because they are all Goras, whites, and I'm Indian and I'm feeling shy and they are Hare Rama, Hare Krishna. Main thodi der ke liye bhi kya mai ka dekha, ajeeb lag raha hai yaar, chhod diya. But I like, and free book, Bhagavad Gita, beautiful picture of Krishna and, on it. I took two books. And best part, I went home, Bhagavad Gita, pata nahi, suna toh bahut hai, dekha bhi hai, lekin kabhi padha nahi. Opened with English commentary, read one paragraph, I had the best sleep. I had the best sleep. I am fantastic, man. Because going to uni in the morning, studying and working in the night, come back at 1 o'clock. Yes, you are tired, but some days it becomes too much. You are so hyper that sleep never used to come. But that day, oh my God, I didn't even read the one verse translation complete. Deep sleep. But yeah, tamas. But today, it's different. Every word is like a divine interaction. It's an expression of the divine. Was this the disposition 30 years ago? No. Look at yourself. When you started coming to Sanskrit class and then to Bhagavad, that time what was your understanding and what is your understanding today? So much different. So here the teacher, the Bhagwan is saying that every person, all these seven rishis and all these different species of beings in this creation, the Kim Purushas, Kinnaras, Gandharvas, etc., Manushya, etc., each one is born because of a special mixture of sattva, rajas and tamas. Purity, sattva, dynamism, rajas, and laziness and inadvertence, tamas. And they are, and this is what makes us as an individual. This equipment is functioning because of that only. Your lot, what you have got, is because of these three. So here he says, continuing. And because of this, different proportions in each one interprets the scriptures in a different way. Yet you see, great masters, when they speak, everyone feels that the master is speaking to them. Right? Everyone feels that their questions are, this was my question, and it get one word from the master and it answers so many people's questions, isn't it? Because his attention is not on the diversity. His attention is on that unifying principle. And because he is coming from that unifying point, standpoint, it satisfies automatically everyone. Our speech does not satisfy our children only. Beta nahi karna hai. Kyun nahi karna? Karna hai. No chocolate, no ice cream. Today they had ice cream, I think. You had ice cream today? You did. See? Pakad liya. So here he says in the next verse, Ya bhir bhutani bhidyante bhutanam matayas tatha yatha prakriti sarvesham chitravacha sravantihi. In the seventh verse he says, sravanti. Sravanti is the flow of the Veda depends upon the admixture of these three gunas in what measure they are in each person. Now we go to the eighth verse. Eighth verse is, evam prakriti vaichitriyat bhidyante matayo nrunam paramparyena keshanchit pakhanda matayo pare. He says that in this way, what with the diversity of disposition and what with the oral teaching imparted from father to son, the minds of some men get perverted while others embrace heroic views. Isko bolte hain hind distortion. This is called distortion. Over a period of time, things get distorted. In some houses, you must have also come across, or maybe in your house also, this thought was prevalent. If you put a mural of Krishna giving the Bhagavad Gita to Arjuna in the middle of the two armies, in your house also Mahabharata will be there. And they never used to put that photograph. We also have at our mom's house. We'll keep fighting. Tom and Jerry. Sometimes she takes me for a firki, sometimes I take her for a firki. Divine game. होता है ना, in some places Bhagavad Gita should not be read, it should be read only to the dead person. You open Bhagavad Gita only when someone dies. In many parts of, see, wrong notion. So where did this pratha ko kya bolte hain, practice, where did this practice begin from? Somewhere it must have started, na? So these wrong notions, these superstitions on account of that, and they very confidently say it is given in the scriptures. Pata hai nahi ki where it is given. Some Mahatma told. Which Mahatma? That also they don't know. Maybe that Mahatma was also of that type only. He must have heard it from his guru. His guru must have got it wrong. He must have got it wrong. See? Some people say, oh, this particular day is very bad to do anything, must not do anything. Superstition. Where is it written? If cat crosses, you should not cross the road. Right? Bhagavad Gita mein likha.
Bad luck for cat.
Cat. See? So these unfounded notions, as because people are not pure, they hear, and as it gets passed on from one mouth to the other, from one generation to the next, because of the impurity, automatically the interpretation of it also changes. And that is what is told here in the 8th verse. Then in the 9th verse he says, what? Man maya mohita dhiyaha purusha purusharshabha shreyo vadantyane kantam yatha karma yatha ruchihi. In the 9th verse he says that with their judgment clouded by my deluding potency, O jewel among men, people speak of different ways to attain blessedness according to their own past karmas and taste. See how many different aspects he is bringing in. Why people follow different paths, or why people behave in a particular way, or how, why people understand scriptures in a different way. So we should not put people into boxes. Hey, ye to karma yogi hai. Like when we were studying, I never knew sattva rajas tamas karke koi cheez bhi hoti hai karke. वैसे भी है नहीं, बट स्क्रिप्चर्स में है. बट व्हेन आई वेंट टू द आश्रम, विद इन द फर्स्ट टू थ्री लेसन्स ओनली वी केम टू नो देयर समथिंग कॉल्ड सत्व रजस्तम. अच्छा, रजसिक फेलो गोइंग ऑन, बिकॉज़ ही इज डूइंग ऑलवेज, समवन इज स्लीपिंग, ए तमसिक गेट अप, एंड वी आर नेम्ड, ए 40% तमस कम. वी स्टार्टेड लेबलिंग एवरीवन लाइक दैट. Misunderstanding. अभी भी एक दो को ऐसे ही बोलते हैं. रजस आ गया. So why do we behave in this manner? Why do we interpret it in this manner? Is there a way out of this? That will come afterwards. But why do we do it? Because of the deluding potency of the Lord, because of the Maya. I'll throw you like that. I saw you. Don't shrug your shoulders. Huh? So based upon our past karmas, see, our life at this moment, whatever your personality is, did you create your personality? Did you create this type of body? Did you demand these type of experiences? Sala 5 saal se ghar ban hi nahi raha. सारे पापड़ बेल लिए और ये महात्मा जाते हैं अगले दिन घर बना लेते हैं. क्यों ऐसे क्यों? Why this much? It's all because of the past karma. So your understanding will be dependent, will be colored by what has come from previous, isn't it? उसका भी तोड़ है यहाँ पे. सिर्फ ओनली फॉर एक्सप्लेनेशन वी आर सेइंग लाइक दिस, बट एंड द तोड़ इज देयर. दिस इज व्हाट द टॉपिक इज. सो हियर ही सेज दैट अकॉर्डिंग, सो दे विल फॉलो सम, ईच पर्सन विल हैव एन इनर पुल टुवर्ड्स अ सर्टेन पाथ. सी, did I I told you about that child who is speaking on Bhagavat, 8-year-old. How did it begin? Some past life, samskaras will be there, past life impressions will be there. When I began my journey, it was all experimentation. Tratak and Kundalini. Experimentation. Not knowing what it is, just experiment. Because I read it somewhere. But today, am I doing that? Am I doing Tratak? No. Am I practicing Kundalini Abhyas? No. Because understanding is different about the same thing. See? So that time it was more body orientation. Now it is also body orientation. Now it is food orientation which makes me talk like this. So change is happening, but you, that time, even if knowledge was present in front of me, my disposition was something needs to be done in order to grow spiritually. Something needs to be done. And this urge from inside to purify myself, it was so great that you take me to Bhagavat, I'll go to sleep. If you take me to Bhagavad Gita, I'll go to sleep. But if you tell me to do Kundalini Abhyas, Yoga Abhyas, Pranayam, I can do it all night. But you take me to Bhagavat, I'll go to sleep. Staying power was not there. It was, I have to do something. Here I'm not doing anything, I'm only listening. So ja, kuch nahi kar rahe. But that was the disposition that time. Now it's a completely opposite. So that is the point, that is that the different ways to attain blessedness according to their own past karma and taste of what they want to get out of it. It depends upon what type of thoughts you are entertaining. Your thoughts will be dependent on what type of mood is there. Is it sattvic mood, is it rajasic mood, or is it tamasic mood? And that, these are the three which have gone into who you are at this moment. So always work towards sattva, it will automatically happen. But here his Lord says that think about me. Automatically, you don't worry about sattva, rajas, tamas. No point. Because they are cyclical and they are a phenomena. There is nothing called sattva, rajas, tamas in the first place. You come to me. You try to come out of that, again you will get caught up because you are still thinking about the three. Anyway, so here he continues in the 10th verse. Dharma meke yashaschanye kamam satyam damam shamam anye vadanti swartham va aishwaryam tyaga bhojanam. 10th verse, he says, some, the advocates of karma mimamsa, declare it to be dharma, religious merit, that you have to do karma kanda, you have to do havan, matru devo bhava, pitru devo bhava, acharya devo bhava, atiti devo bhava, and lage raho din bhar, subay se leke sham tak, subay, dupair, subay, subay, get up at 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, take shower, sweep, clean, puja, havan, this, that, meditation, japa. Whole day must be accounted for by doing some karma kand. Everything, in other words, everything, their attention is on doing something. Then, yet there are others.
Not just doing, getting something out of
it. Something, that is also true, because their attention is on the world. See, why do we do something? Why a karta is born? Karta means doer. Why is a doer born? Because he wants to be a bhokta. He wants to enjoy the fruits of his action. He wants to enjoy the... If his attention is not on the fruits, very quickly doership will go away. Action will continue, but doership will not be there. Think. Again, a subtle alignment within yourself. Are you doing whatever you are doing to get something? Or is it an expression of bliss and joy? Or you are taking it, whatever is happening by grace. If your attention is on grace, it will be a joyful disposition all the time. So, karta is only because of bhokta. You cannot have only karta and no bhokta. They appear together. And those who are karma kandis, as he said, our scriptures also say the same thing, that there is a result. When you do havan, sarva loka samasta sukhino bhavanti. Are tumko kisi ne bola hai? Someone has given you the responsibility. Loka samasta sukhino bhavanti. God came and told you that pray for the whole world. Did he? They have not told anyone. Vedas say only think about the divine. He will also say the same thing in this chapter. So who is thinking of loka samasta sukhino bhavantu? Whose attention is on the loka. Then only this prayer will come out, no? But he whose attention is on the divine and he understands that the whole world is in the divine itself, as the divine itself, will he say loka sukhino, loka samasta loka sukhino bhavantu?
Seva manubha.
Huh?
It will be seva manubha. We'll do karma but in the seva way.
That is still karma. Karma should be done only for one purpose. What is that?
Purification.
Seva must be done only for one purpose. Seva is karma. If your disposition is towards that, it should be done only for one purpose, and that is purification of your, not body, mind. Purification of mind means only one thing. Karmanneva adhikaraste ma phaleshu kadachana. Do all the actions of your life without expecting anything in return. And do that which is coming in front of you. Don't desire anything to do anything. Because if there is a desire, then there is a result also. See? Then purification will happen. Otherwise, we are lost in our karma, 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 karma. But here we are talking about different dispositions. Some people follow that way. Then what are the others? It advocates karma mimamsa, declare it to be dharma, religious merit, that you have to, whole life is about collecting merit, 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 because we must, and one must be very careful not to do something wrong. You must not touch, you must not eat food without washing your hands, you must not eat breakfast without taking shower, you must not go out of the house without lighting a lamp, you must not, so many things you can continue there. Some places, until Agnihotra is not done, they will not leave the house, isn't it? They live in fear that I might go the wrong way, and therefore they want to do the right way. And what will happen if you do the right way? You will not go to God. Where will you go? Those who think about loka samasta sukhino bhavantu, they will only go to heaven. That's all. That is if you have collected enough merit. In your head you are thinking, I am doing meritorious deeds, but from God's point of view you are bloody cheating him. So where will you go? Hell. He will make pakoda of you and fry in the hot oil and you will not die. Remember that example came when the description of hell came. From God's point of view, there is nothing called merit and there is nothing called demerit. Nothing like that. Because he is complete. So you must, as a devotee of the Lord, we must not also think about collecting merit. We must purify so that we can come to the divine. Others, the poets call it renown, they sing his glory. Still other such as Vatsayana name it as sexual enjoyment, that is the union of the two. And then what is the other one? And some advocates of yoga designated as truthfulness, control of the senses and mind controls. Others such as politicians speak of wealth and power as their well-known end, and the policies of conciliation etc. as the means to that end. Advocates of renunciation declare it as renunciation, while hedonists call it sensual enjoyment. And this way each one is making his own interpretation of the whole thing. What do we call? What do we call it? Our duty is what? Taking care of children. उसी में फंस जाते हैं ना. But see, this world is full of variety, and each one is interpreting it in his own manner, depending upon their own disposition. You want to sort out that disposition. Oh, I did not create this disposition, I am automatically. Let it be. Let it happen. Let it happen. Dattatreya Maharaj, he learned from a Vaishya also. Remember that story? That Vaishya who sleeps with so many customers. What did you say?
Vaishya.
But she decided, with so many, what is the point? Still I am not satisfied. And she puts her attention on the Lord. And even after living that type of life, she shifts her attention to the Lord. And everything is neutralized. Everything is purified from her. So there's enough to learn from everything in our life. See, one Mahatma was there. Sri Aurobindo. He went to America. And when he went to America, he was sitting in some park. And he was, park means in some garden, and special garden. And he saw one gardener. He looked at him. Who is this? And someone came and told his whole biography. He's from Denmark and he did not have enough food to eat there and he was finding it hard, so he migrated here and now he's working here as a gardener. He called him, hey, come here, this is not your karma bhumi, go to Pondicherry. Sent him to Pondicherry. He went there 3 days or 3-4 days. He stayed in Pondicherry enough, went to Ramanashram. 3 days he sat in front of Ramana. See how life unfolded for him. 3 days he sat in front of Ramana Bhagavan. After 3 days, Ramana Bhagavan, first time he spoke to him after 3 days. He says, Shunya. He left Ramanashram. 60 plus years, he lived in Almoda in the Himalayas. In Kumaon region. 60 years. Silent. Shunya. I am Shunya. Shunya means zero. Ramana Maharishi told him Shunya. He said Shunyata. And he took it to his name. And then for 60 years. And some Americans came. They are all traveling. They found him. Because Neem Karoli Baba Ashram is there. The Mahatar Babaji Ashram is there. So they found him there. The word must have spread because he was sitting in one cave for 60 years, not interacting with the world. But these few fellows came, they said, oh Guruji, we found our God, this, that is. For him it did not matter. It was India. Eventually they forced him, picked him up, took him to America. They built an ashram for him, he was living there. Must not have lived even for 6 months. One day he was going out for a walk, a truck came. Story over. And here we are planning our life, you know. That's what I'm... Kitne interestingly you are listening to the story. But you are planning your life. Tomorrow I'm going to do this. Day after tomorrow I'm going to do this. After 1 year my child is going to be that much he must have studied and gone. Enjoy. Enjoy means let every activity that is happening be an expression of joy. And that will only happen when we are surrendered to the Lord. And then here he says in the 11th verse, Kechid yajnatapodanam vratani niyamanam yaman adyantavanta evaisham loka karva vinirmitaha. He says that some call it yajna, worship of God, some others speak of it as austerity, liberality, sacred vows, observances, and the five forms of abnegation. The rewards of these are indeed such as having a beginning and an end, fruits as they are of human endeavor. See, hum vrat karte hain. Abhi thode din pehle ki baat hai. Kya tha? Sankashti thi na. Vidyavar Karwa Chauth tha. You know, I don't know. How do I know? How do I know Karwa Chauth kya hota hai? I know what it is, but when it was, I don't know. So, fast. Because Vidya told mom, auntie, tomorrow Sankashti. So mummy decided, oh, for so many times I have missed Sankashti. So I should fast today. But from morning she's thinking, I have to wet the sabudana. I have to, from morning, I have to grind the dana, peanuts. And then I came down at 10:30, still the thought is there. Yeah, you're going to eat sabudana khichdi? No, why? No, today is Sankashti. Acha. Then, so whole morning, we are only thinking about what we are going to eat. It's an example. But you are the example. But this is how you go to a Marwadi house. Oh man, the best food on any fasting day. Best food. If you go to ashrams, best food on Ekadashi day. Where I used to live in Varanasi, in Kashi. Upvas ke din, my God, they will make the aloo ki tari. They will make singade ke aate ki puri. Singade ke aate ke pakode. Aloo ki sabji, wo dana wana dal ke jo bana tha, uski sabji. And varache tando hote na, wo tuta hua rice hota hai, kya bolte hai usko? Some special rice is there. Usko. Itna. और वो पकोड़े और पूरी जो खाते थे उसका तो मजा ही आया था आलू की सब्जी के साथ. अरे सो वी यूज्ड टू वेट कब आएगा कि आज अच्छा है, आज दवा के खाना है, क्योंकि रोज रोटी दाल सब्जी चावल मिलता था. ऑन दैट डे फैंटास्टिक. बट व्हाट इज इट सपोज टू बी फॉर? इट इज सपोज टू बी टू गिव अ रेस्ट टू योर सिस्टम. बट दैट डे यू आर लोडिंग द सिस्टम इवन मोर विद ऑल दीज थिंग्स. Sabudana takes long time to digest. Long time, it stays there. And then the last one. Dukho darkastamo nishtha kshudrananda shucharpitaha. He says, they bring sorrow in their train, culminate in ignorance, afford trivial delight, and are attended with grief even when they are being enjoyed. Meaning, whatever, if your attention is on the world, if your activity is for gaining something from this world, all of us, remember, if our actions are to gain something from this world, if we are enjoying something in this world, inherent within it is grief, sorrow, disease, unhappiness, and you will never, the joy, the bliss that you are seeking by interacting with the world, that is going to slip even while you are interacting with it. So recognize this. Then you're all nodding. You're all nodding. But you have to practice, you have to be aware of this when the next question comes, when the next experience comes to you. You have to remember that. Not to get swayed. Not to expect. See the nirapeksha. Here, wait, was that the verse somewhere?
In the next verse.
Hmm?
In the next verse, Swami.
Yeah. Ah, nirapeksha. Next verse it is there. So the more, if we have an expectation from the world, if I am going to study, I am going to get this. If I am going to eat, no, better. If I give this lecture, then I am going to get bhiksha. Huh? If this is the expectation, if this is the expectation, then you are in trouble. Someone yesterday told me, SMS me, Swamiji, can you come next Diwali, na, next Sunday? So, next Sunday no class, Divinay. Sanskrit class, agle Sunday nahi hai. Nahi, is Sunday hai, agle Sunday nahi hai. Kal hai, next Sunday nahi, Diwali hai. So, they have called. So, Swamiji, do you eat onions, do you eat garlic? तो पहले बोला कि आ जाओ, मैंने कहा ठीक है. स्वामी सत्संग करेंगे? हाँ करेंगे. मैंने कहा खाना मिलेगा? हाँ मिलेगा. फिर 15 मिनट के बाद ऐसे में आया, स्वामी जी अनियंस एंड गार्लिक चलेगा? मैंने कहा प्रेफर नो गार्लिक, प्रेफर लेस अनियंस, बट इफ सम डिश डजंट कैन नॉट बी मेड विदाउट इट, इट्स ओके, देन व्हाट कैन आई डू, देन इट इज माय चॉइस वेदर आई ईट इट और नॉट. शी सेज गॉट इट. क्या क्या होगा देखेंगे अगली बार, नेक्स्ट संडे पता चलेगा, देन यू विल गेट इट इन द वीक आफ्टर लेक्चर, द डाउनलोड विल बी देयर. सी, सो इन दिस वे अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट वी स्टडीड टुडे. व्हाट वाज द मेन टॉपिक भगवान इज टेलिंग अस हियर? थिंक इन लास्ट 1.5 hours व्हाट हैव वी डन, हाउ. That's one part. What else?
People take according to their taste.
People take, people
interpret
the Vedas according to their admixture of gunas
and temperament
and environment and what they have got from their previous teachers or gurus or family or fathers or mothers. So what is the learning? Then why did we spend 1.5 hours? What is the learning here?
I want to be clear. After all, what we are trying to achieve? All this fulfillment is okay. Because desire
of
is
propensity
for especially for grasp for us. But what is that we are trying to achieve after all? If that goal of life, human life, is not clear,
so when you say that for us grahasthas we have to do
karma,
we have to do, listen to what he is saying, for us grahasthas karma we have to do, but if the goal of life is missed, then everything goes hanky haywire, isn't it? But here he is wrong. For grahasthas, remember what we said in the beginning of this talk, for the grahasthas, what they have to do is to remember the Lord, because the ultimate purpose of life is to be with the God, no? But grahasthas are thinking that they have to do something in order to maintain their family. They have to do something to maintain the body. they have to do something to maintain the relationships. But as long as your attention is on this, you will not be available to the Lord. And when you are available to the Lord, then everything gets taken care of by itself anyway. And the second thing that we, that was for one part of it, the main point that we start from these 10-11 verses we have seen is that it is that one alone who is expressing as the karma mark, the jnana mark, the Vedas are the same, but that one alone has become the rishis, that one alone has become Brahmaji, that one alone has become the Sanat Kumaras, that one alone has become the Manu and the various species of beings. And that Vani, the speech, the interpretation of each one as each one of them, can it happen without that one? No. Because life is expressing in one, every one of them, isn't it? So understand, our understanding here is that in spite of the many ways that this one divine is expressing, that one is not contaminated. Now you apply it on yourself. Even though we are one, we get contaminated due to conditioning. We allow the conditionings to dictate. Mother dictates the son, for son behaves differently. Then the students today in Sanskrit class, Swamiji, the class was fantastic. Today, aaj kya bata, ek choti si baat hai tha. One young girl came, and she comes here, Srinika, you know, the small girl, Sri Ram and Srinika, she came. And she came with the notebook and everything, and she said, I am going to study, and my brother is studying, I am also going to, 5-year-old. So last week she came, and she found it very difficult. And mummy said, Swamiji, she is complaining that it is very difficult to write. And she says, I only go to class because I like to watch Swamiji's beard and play with it. Now I found, the moment mother said this, I said, good, Srinika, come here. She says, yes. You find it hard to write? So I said, okay, write a. If you write a 10 times with one finger, you can touch my beard. If you write a 10 times with two fingers, you can touch two times. Badmash ne phatapat sare alphabet sikhe. Both hands se what she, for last 3 weeks, she was in one class, she completed everything. उसके सामने लड्डू रख दिया. So they said the class was very good. So are they validating the teacher? Are we validating God, that God created this? God does not remain affected even though he is supporting the expression of the variety. And we have to recognize that one unaffected principle is expressing through us at this present moment. That is the true dharma. That is the true dharma. Everything else is secondary. This whole explanation was not to tell you how creation is. The whole explanation is so that you come to that one because of whom all these expressions are there. With this thought, we'll conclude. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shantihi. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.